Man, guys, I know you guys are looking at the title right now and are like, this video is just completely overdue. It is really overdue. You guys been asking for this video for like, I don't even know how long. Like, all I gotta say really is thank you guys for your patience, because like, I know, like, and the real reason why I haven't made it is because in the past, I really didn't have a night method. I honestly really didn't. And I didn't want to, like, say, throw something out there and say, here's my night method. And I didn't even really have one myself. So now that I actually have a night method, something that I usually consistently do daily, I was like, all right, now I'm ready to finally do this night method. I know y'all been waiting for a long time. But man, I mean, I ain't cheating now. I ain't cheating, cause I wanted it to be night. Like, look at it. Look, guys, it's night. It's night outside. It's night. Okay. It's getting dark outside. So you guys can't, you know, it's not during the day. It's nighttime. This is like, I'm making basically this video of me actually doing something that I do at night, but I hope y'all are ready for this long overdue method that I should have, you know, that I probably should have put out there a long time ago and had my own night method a long time ago, because I feel like a night method, it is really important, because that's the last brush session of the day. Like, that's your last brush session. Let's just go ahead, get into it. We're actually gonna be in the bathroom the whole entire time, because that's my routine. I'm always in the bathroom. Let's stop wasting time. Let's get into it. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Now.
Wait. Hold on. Okay.
Before you guys get into this video, I would like to apologize now. You know, before we actually got into the video, because this is a long video, as you guys can see as on the timer. I just want to apologize now because it's a long video, but it was needed, okay? It was needed. And I just, like, I want to say, maybe take me in the bathroom with you. Don't take that the wrong way. Don't take that the wrong way. But take me in the bathroom with you, and we brush together. It might seem like it's going faster, you know? Because you actually have something to brush with. You have, you know, it, I don't know what it is. It might just be easier. I'm not saying that you have to, but it might be easier, you know what I'm saying? But I just had to say that before we got, you know, actually into the bathroom and I started, you know, explaining this method to you guys. Okay, but now I got that out the way. Now let's get back to the video. Alright guys, like I said, we are back in the bathroom, you know, just like how the old videos used to be. We were straight in the bathroom the whole time. Now, the reason why, you know, we're in the bathroom, like I said, is because this is where the real brush sessions happen. You know, you got to use your mirror at night. This is something you're going to need, you know, at night. You're going to need your mirror because you don't want to blind brush, you know. You don't want to blind brush in the morning and at night. During the day, it's fine. You know, you can blind brush. If you don't know what blind brushing is, it's brushing, you know, without a mirror. It's just you in the day just going like this, you know what I'm saying? You're just brushing, all right? So that's blind brushing. This is not blind brushing. We have a mirror, you know, and then you're actually, you know, seeing what you're doing in the mirror. It's very, you're brushing very accurately. That's what, you know, that's what usually you prefer to do, but it's okay to blind brush if you actually know the pattern you're supposed to be brushing in. The reason why is, you know, you don't want to blind brush is because it helps you prevent forks from brushing the wrong way. That's how you get forks, if you didn't know. But I have nothing in my hair right now, nothing at all. My hair is completely bone dry, as you just saw when I, you know, showed you guys my way. At night, I usually like to use my curling hamster smoothie or Cantu, whatever you guys prefer. And then spinning ways, I don't know, it's been working really good for my night methods. You know, I don't know what it is, but And then another thing, of course, you're gonna need your do-rag, brush, of course. You know, this is my medium brush. I'm in 4 weeks of wolfing, four or five weeks of wolfing right now. So I'm still using my medium brush and also a soft brush. I feel like when at your night method, you should use a soft brush and also a comb. You know, that I feel like every hair waver should already have a comb. If you don't have a comb, you've been doing something wrong. All right, but this is, you know, I'm gonna do it, and I'm just gonna, like, you know, talk through what I'm doing so you guys know, you know, because I feel like if it's just better if you guys watch and if I comment on different things that I'm doing. So let's just get it. All right, guys, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna spray some water. I don't want, since my hair is like bone dry right now, I usually like to, you know, get some water in my hair. You know, not, I like to get a spray bottle because, I mean, I feel like it puts the right amount of water in your hair and it doesn't, like, dry. If you don't have a spray bottle, it's cool, you know? It's cool, just get some water from the faucet, get your hands wet, and go in. You don't wanna get your hair too wet because you guys already know when your hair is too wet, your hair starts to disappear, and that's no good for this, all right? So then, I like to just go in with my softy and just, you know, get a quick session while the water is in there. You go ahead. All right, see, like I said, just a quick session, nothing long with the softy, all right, nothing long. And then I think, I haven't used my curling hair smoothie. I've been using really my spinning waves a lot more. So I think I'm gonna go with my curling hair smoothie. And I'm not gonna get too much, but I wanna get a good amount since, you know, I do still have a good amount of hair on my head. I'm gonna get about this much. It's not too much, not too little, you know? And like I said, you can always add more, but you can't take it out. And if you do, then you gotta wash your hair, and I ain't trying to do that. So you're just gonna go like this for a while. All right, now that your hands are all white, you're just gonna apply the product in your hair and, you know, do more of a hand brush session. Now that you got it all in your hair, take a rag, you know, get it all off your hands. You know, don't be touching your brushes with, you know, products still left in your hands. You know, just take a brush, I mean a washcloth, and get it off your hands. All right, now we got it all off our hands. Now we're gonna take our comb. I usually take my comb, and I just get a good, you know, combing it in my hair. I don't know, I feel like it helps penetrate the product deeper in my hair. So let's get it. I got a little curl standing up. I don't know if y'all can see that. Look at that. It's cool. Don't worry about it. We're just gonna go ahead. We're gonna just lay down those curls. Now we're grabbing our medium brush. All right, now we're gonna grab our medium brush. We're just gonna go ahead and get a brush session in. Now this brush session, it's gonna be not too long, not too short. It's gonna be right in the middle. So I'm gonna just stop talking. And by the way, I forgot to tell you guys, yes, I'm shifting. I'm not in 360s anymore. I'm shifting my pattern to 540s. So just in case you're like, man, this man ain't brushing like his 360s, because I'm shifting. Just so we can get that out the way. So let's go ahead with, let's get in this brush set. Alright, guys. See? This is about like a 5-minute brush session. That's not too bad, you know? Then, after, you know, now my hair is pretty much starting to lay down now. It's actually starting to lay down. You know what I'm saying? See? It's just a little bit, but like I said, not that big of a deal. I'm wolfing, I'll put curling hair smoothie in my hair, but it's gonna lay down, I promise you guys. But we're gonna go in with our softy now. And when I go in, now it's gonna, again, not too long. It's just gonna be right in the middle, you know, type brush session, another about 5 minutes. And then, you know, so let's just get in it. So, not too bad. You know, it's about 3-minute brush session. Like I said, I didn't want to make it too long. Didn't want to make it, you know, too short. Pretty much in the middle. Now we're gonna take your comb, and like I said, comb always helps with connections and different things like that. So you, and it also helps with depth. A lot of you guys ask me, you know, how do I get depth in my waves? Comb is a good way to start. You know, if you're already doing the comb. And there's some other methods that, you know, if you guys want to see, you know, let me know. And I would definitely show you guys how I get depth in my waves. But let's go ahead. Let's get into this little comb session. Just so y'all can see a little better. Alright, now I'd like to finish it up a little bit. You know, I know this is a long video, I know it's a long video, but then I like to, you know, you guys already know how I am. I like to get 100 strokes on the top, each side, which is about, I think it was 500 strokes. So it's 100 here, both 100 on each side, the back, and then you try to work on your crown a little bit. You know, get, you know, I know what they say, you know, you want to focus on getting the waves first, but you also have to start making your crown so it's not that hard when you have to, you know, put it together all with your waves. Here we go, ready, set, go. That was a pretty good burst session, you know what I'm saying? It's not gonna be long after this. It's pretty much over now. All we're gonna do is take our softy, we're gonna take our comb again, and we're just gonna, you know, really quick, just real quick, get it in. So we're gonna take our comb first, and we're just gonna go across the pattern. I like to go all the way across about 5 times, and then we'll go back. So let's hurry up and let's get this comb in. The hair and the death, you know, and I like to do this especially when wolfing, when you're combing a lot, because the depth of your waves is going to show when you get your hair cut. So just remember that. But then we're going to take our soft brush, and this is like the ending factor. This is like, you know, this is the final stage before you rag it up. All right, rag it up before you go to bed, you know. All right, so let's get into it.
Yeah, I feel like I'm the one with the sauce. Chef Lagasse with the pans and the pots. And want the recipe, ain't that a first? Even if I gave it to them, they would not know how to stir it. They would not know how to stir it, stir it, stir it, stir it, stir it, stir it, stir it. Stir it, stir it, stir it, stir it, stir it. They would not know how to stir it, stir it, stir it, stir it, stir it. Even if I gave it to them, they would not know how to stir it. They would not know how to chef. Hey, watch me cut, cut. Fresh as fire, you might see me in a look, but should've known I was coming.
Alright. Now, you know, I'm trying to get my waves back on elite status. You know, I don't feel like my waves are at elite status right now ever since I started shifting. You know, you guys let me know, alright? You guys tell me. Are they? Are they? Here, let's see. Are they? Huh? You know, they're not the best. They're not the best right now. But, you know, we're going to get them back. We're going to get them back to the status we had them at. You know? We're going to get them back. And, you know, I shifted my pattern because I was like, I don't know, I felt like 360s were just too easy for me, you know, it felt like a boring pattern, you know, it wasn't me. I like things that, you know, stand out more to the eye, you know, for a straight hair waver to have a hybrid, you know, I feel like that's crazy, like that makes, that, you're looking on Instagram and things like that, you're scrolling through, and you see hybrid straight hair waver, and then you see, you know, a 360 waver. You know, what eye, you know, which one would you think was better? Even though they're both at elite status, which one would you think is better? I feel like hybrids, you know, they just stand out more for a straight hair waver because you're like, dang, you know, I feel like straight hair wavers, it's common for them to get 360s. And I don't want to be common. I don't want to be, you know, like everybody else, which is nothing wrong with that, you know. I just wanted to try something different. I'm going to get them back on top, just like how I had my 360s. But, you know, it all takes hard work, dedication, and consistency. You know, you can't have, if you're constantly having to be motivated by things that you see on Instagram, or you're watching, you know, YouTube videos, and you see, dang, like his waves is spinning, look at mine. You hurry up, you jump in the bathroom, you're brushing. You know, you're not self-motivated. Self-motivated is very important. And I tell you this because, like, the motivation, when you see the Instagram post, it's going to get old. You're going to be like, ah, well, you're not going to want to jump in, you know, the bathroom and start brushing anymore. It's kind of going to get old. But when you're self-motivated, self-motivation doesn't get old. You can constantly, you know, you're constantly keeping up with what, you know, you want to accomplish. And what I want to accomplish is to have, I want to be an elite waiter. I want to be on that status, you know what I'm saying? But that's my night method, all right, you guys? Yes, it was a long video. It is a long video. And I just say, just hop in the bathroom, you know, if you made it all the way to the end of the video, just, I feel like it's easier when you're brushing along with somebody. The process goes, you know, goes by a lot, you know, quicker than just, you know, in complete silence, you know, or throw some music on, you know, while you're doing this method. It really helps, you know, it makes the time go by faster. You know what we forgot to do? We forgot to rag it up. You know, you don't ever forget to rag it up. You know, I might have to get, don't judge my do-rag, you know. I'm tough on my do-rags, you know. But you want to rag it up, save that progress. And, you know, but I feel like if you do this method every night, I feel like your ways, they're going to get on point, you know. Because like I said, this is the last brush session of the day. This ain't blind brushing. You gotta be in the mirror. You gotta have your mirror with the mirror, okay? You know, you gotta have two mirrors now. And you gotta actually see what you're doing. You know what I'm saying? You gotta see the pattern you're brushing in to make sure that you're not brushing incorrectly. So, guys, just stay consistent. I promise you guys will see progress, you'll see depth, you'll see better connections. You'll just see all around, you know, if you're a beginner, you'll see better ripples. So that's the end of the method. Like I always say, like, comment, subscribe. But like I said, I got one more thing to say. And it's 360 Woods.